Clock in, clock in. Black guy just walked in.
Yeah. That dumbass. He already dead. There ain't no need to check his vitals, bitch.
I had somebody pull up some shit. Yeah.
He already dead. There ain't no need to check his vitals. Yeah. Crunch time. Yeah, nigga, it's lunch time. Let go. Crunch time. Yeah, nigga, it's lunch time.
Let go.
Yeah. Crunch time. Yeah, nigga, it's lunch time. Let go. Crunch time. Yeah, nigga, it's lunch time. He dead.
Team Black got to stand up, man.
Yeah.
Right now, very interesting video. And this is with rappers who got ran up on. Yeah. Ran up on. You feel me? Now, Uncle Fruge right now, because I don't know too many rappers who got ran up on, technically. But I'ma see what the hell is they finna make out of this video. You feel me? If you woke up this morning and brushed your teeth, like the video. If you didn't, go brush your teeth and come back, then like the video. Matter of fact, if your breath hot, just say I ain't brushed yet in the comments. Just watch the video, bro. Y'all good. You feel me?
Being a famous rapper can be dangerous. When your ops want you dead, but you also constantly doing shows and dropping your location on social media, you never know what's gonna happen. Here's a few famous rappers who got ran up on. Yo Gotti. Yo Gotti's a Memphis legend. He's from the Fraser neighborhood of North Memphis and started rapping at age 14 under the name Lil Yo. He dropped multiple independent projects before releasing his debut major album, Live from the Kitchen, in 2012. 2 years later, he started his own label, Cocaine Music Group, now just CMG. Through his label, he signed multiple major rappers, including Moneybagg Yo, 42 Doug, ESTG, and Black Youngsta.
No cap, Yo Gotti got one of the hardest labels in the game right now. Ain't nobody messing with his label right now, you feel me?
Street legend can't save you from everything. And recently, someone ran up on Yo Gotti and tried to rob him of his jewelry as he was leaving the club in Memphis. Gotti was standing by his car fully iced out when a dude comes out of nowhere with a gun. Surveillance footage from the parking lot shows him walk up and get real close to Yo Gotti. He tries to take off his jewelry, and at first, the rapper just plays it cool. Gotti acts like he's trying to take off his watch, but suddenly throws a punch at the dude and tries to knock the gun out of his hand.
Get right.
He knocked away the gun, and the robber fired a shot but missed the rapper. The gunshot must have attracted too much attention because the dude just hopped back in his whip and smashed off without taking anything.
Oh, you can tell he ain't never robbed nothing before. Oh my God.
He said, pew, pew, why you ain't let me rob you? Pew, face sad, why you shot like that?
And the robber fired a shot but missed the rapper. The gunshot must have attracted too much attention because the dude just hopped back in his whip and smashed off without taking anything. The footage quickly went viral after the incident. They call Yo Gotti a hero for defending himself without even pulling out his own gun.
Gotti just knew he wasn't on shit the moment he said, hey, can you please take off your watch real quick, you feel me? Because they in the car, they say I gotta do this, you feel me? Gotti just punched that boy.
The robber probably thought he could hit a quick lick on a rapper, but ain't realized that Yo Gotti was really in the streets and knows how to move smart. Not long after, the dude who tried to rob Yo Gotti supposedly got his car lit up and he got killed after getting shot.
I knew he died. Damn, Gotti is not playing, but they did not play with that boy.
17 times. Memphis police don't believe Gotti or anyone from his camp was involved in the shooting. The victim was heavy in the streets and robbed a lot of people in Memphis, so anyone could have chipped him. But it shows how fast it comes back around when you're not moving right. But Yo Gotti ain't the only famous rapper to get ran up on.
See, Gotti handled business though. Shit, I call that shit. Ran up on gone wrong.
Was recently in a shootout and got grazed in the leg after he dumped the whole clip. Julio. Julio is one of the most controversial rappers in the game right now.
You talking about the one that say he got shot at 100 times when in all reality, they probably shot at him 4 times. You talking about that one? The one that say he got grazed on the ankle, but whole time he fell in the sidewalk, scraped him. That's the Julio you talking about? The Julio that made a fool of his damn self, trying to lie like that? That's the one you talking about? Just making sure we talking about the same people.
His beef with Young and Ace helped his music blow up, but also got the attention from the ops in the city. Julio's from Jacksonville, Florida. He's from KTA, a gang known to be for Young and Ace and ATK. Both Ace and Julio shocked the world after dropping back-to-back diss songs where they diss each other's dead homies and expose their beef to the world. First, Young and Ace dropped the song Who I Smoke, where he dissed dudes who died that was close to Julio, including his younger brother, Bibby. Then Julio responded with the When I See You remix, where he dissed Ace's homies and brother who got killed in a drive-by back in 2018. So both sides have been beefing for a minute, and now that their music is going viral, the whole world is tapped in. But when you dissing ops in your music and still in the streets, it come back for you. Julio recently has learned that the hard way after being involved in a drive-by shooting where he was grazed by a bullet. Julio posted a video to his Instagram story showing a gun that looks like it just got fired.
Why he keeps saying grazed by a bullet? He got grazed by the sidewalk, sir. It was the concrete. It wasn't no bullet, sir. It was the cement. You feel me? Correction.
He tells the ops that they not real shooters and that he emptied his whole clip. The video also had the caption, "On Trey D, I got right in slides, emptied my whole clip. You boys goofies. I'm not dead, so stop faking for the internet." He also moves the camera to show his leg, which looks like it's bleeding a little, but nothing serious. He says he got grazed and not hit, then followed up the video with another slide with the caption, "Y'all missed a whole 100 shots, literally," along with a bunch of emojis. So, it sounds like the ops was really trying to take him out, but Julio was ready for him. But this ain't the first time Julio been ran up on. Back in February, he got pressed in the mall in Tampa by someone he grew up with. That time, he just played it cool and ignored the dude until he went away. But that was in public around crowds and security cameras, and no one pulled a gun on him. This latest situation seems more serious, and Julio had to defend himself. Julio later faced criticism because it sounded like he was snitching on himself by talking about the shootout on social media. But he got back on live to clarify that the gun was registered and it wasn't snitching because he shot back in self-defense.
Listen, on trading my gun and register, I shot back in self-defense. Y'all dumb. I shot back in self-defense. You know what I'm saying? If I did something illegal, I would be in jail. The police put me in the back of the car, type of shit.
It still ain't clear who he was shooting at or if there was any more victims. But it don't look like Julio was seriously hurt if he was posting about it on IG Live right after. One of Julio's ops, Wapa with the Chopper, a rapper tied in with Young and Ace and ATK, went on social media and hinted he might have something to do with it. He posted slides that had audio from a video game that said, "Mission failed, we'll get them next time." Then he posted a pic of Julio's face as an op pack with the R. Kelly song, "I Wish," in the background. A fan pressed him about being involved in the shooting, and Wapa said he was in Atlanta at the time and had nothing to do with it. But he ain't missed the opportunity to clown one of his ops for saying too much on social media. But Julio ain't the only rapper to get ran up on. This next rapper said his car got sprayed up with bullets while he was stopped in traffic. E-Day 600. E-Day 600 was an early founder of drill music who was close with many big rappers before they got famous, like Chief Keef, King Von, and Lil Durk. E-Day was one of the most respected members from 600, a BD set who was allied with O-Block. He's the older brother of another 600 member named C-Day, who got arrested with Rondo Number 9 for killing a cab driver, and they both got hit for 38 years in prison. E-Day was known for tracks like War With Us and 600 Dead Ops, which are considered drill classics. But E-Day's music never made it as far as some of his homies. He tried to leave the streets alone and become a professional truck driver, but that ain't saving him from being haunted by the streets, and E-Day got murdered down back in August. Throughout his come up, E-Day was active in the streets. In an interview with DJ Vlad, he told a story about when the ops ran up on him and lit his car up with bullets. He said he was driving down 59th Street in the area ran by 600. As he was driving, the ops popped out of nowhere on foot and just started busting shots into his car. He heard the first few shots go off and try to dip, but he was stuck in traffic and couldn't get away. There was two semi-trucks on both sides of him and cars in front and behind him. But eventually, all the gunshots made the other cars start to swerve to avoid getting hit. So, he got to escape before the shooters got to him. When he finally got away, he pulled over to see the damage and saw his car got hit like 26 times. The tires was completely flat, windows was busted out, and there was steam coming from the engine. But somehow, he didn't get hit. He told Vlad that Chicago gang members don't care about doing drills out in the open because it's all about the clout. E-Day was a known face in his city, so the shooters would have gotten a lot of love from their hood for taking him out. E-Day made it out alive that time, but unfortunately, in August 2021, he was shot and killed. But E-Day ain't the only rapper from Chicago to get ran up on. This next rapper was shot a total of 6 times over a 3-year period. 600 Breezy. 600 Breezy is another 600 rapper from the south side of Chicago. He also grew up with Chief Keef, Fredo, and Lil Durk, and was cool with all the other BD rappers. 600 Breezy grew up in the Calumet building, and his pops was a GD. Breezy started out as a GD, but later flipped to BD after they started taking over the hood. Breezy has faced some hate from his ops for switching sides, but he says he only claimed GD when he was a kid and ain't know what he was doing. But when he hopped up the porch for real, he was banging BD. Growing up in Chirac, 600 Breezy dealt with violence from an early age. In an interview with DJ Vlad, he talks about being shot at just 14 years old. He and some 600 members used to fight dudes from other hoods, and they was known for beating up their ops and embarrassing them in front of their girls. Until one day, the ops came back with guns and started shooting. After that, they had to get their own guns to protect themselves, and the violence just took off from there. When he was 21, he got shot in the hand and leg, being fresh out of jail. Breezy ran away and made it 4 blocks before collapsing, but ain't even realize he got shot till his legs gave out. He got hit by a Deuce 5, which is so small that it can't really kill you, but it could have done a lot more damage if it hit him somewhere else. After that, he kept getting shot every year for the next few years and got hit a total of 6 times. But luckily, he was only shot in the hand, leg, and ass. So none of the bullets hit any vital organs or did serious damage. He said the most painful thing was getting shot in the ass. That time, he was out sliding on ops, and karma came back around within 5 minutes. He don't go into much detail, but said it was by far the most painful time he got ran up on, and he think it happened because he was doing something that he had no business doing. He had just got out of jail for a drug case, and his face had been all over the news, so people was out looking for him. But after that, he learned his lesson and started moving smarter, so he ain't end up right back in the same position.
600 Breezy a damn magnet when it come to getting shot, bro. You straight? You leave it too hot out here.
That was crazy. This next rapper got shot in the head and arm during a drive-by after a fight. Bankroll Freddy. Bankroll Freddy is a rapper from Conway, Arkansas, who signed to Quality Control Records along with rappers like the Migos and Lil Baby. Freddy started rapping in 2017, releasing freestyles on Instagram, including a version of Act Up by the City Girls that was part of the hashtag Act Up Challenge. This got the attention of P from Quality Control, who invited Freddy to meet him in LA. In 2019, he dropped a single Drip Like This, which was later remixed by Young Dolph and Lil Baby. Then he dropped the album Trap to Rap in 2020, which featured Moneybagg Yo, Lil Yachty, and Yo Gotti. He followed up with his second project, Big Bank, in 2021, which had guest appearances from Meg Thee Stallion, ESTG, and Gucci Mane. One night, his career was almost cut short before it even got started when his ops ran up on him after a fight. In an interview with DJ Vlad, Freddy tells what went down. He was at a casino when he got into it with another group. He and his homies left the casino to get away, but whoever they was beefing with followed them outside and started chasing them in their own car. As Freddy was driving away, the op sped up behind him and shot through the back window. Freddy got grazed in the head and arm, and his homies almost got hit too. He spent the night in the hospital, but bounced back pretty fast. After that, he said he had to tighten up and move differently so he wouldn't be put in that situation again. He had a kid on the way, and when he woke up in the hospital, he realized that if things went differently, he would have never saw his son. In total, he was shot at like 30 or 40 times and got lucky to only be grazed. But it looks like Freddy took that as a sign to leave the streets alone and focus on his rap career so he don't lose all his blessings for nothing.
Damn, that's crazy. Look at the shit you go through, bro. You feel me? When you got the ability to leave the stuff that you was into and you just choose not to. Some of these niggas just be in too deep. But let me know how y'all feel about this, because I'm about done with that. Clock out, Black Guy. Just walk out.
Okay. I'm out here trying to get paid, but dog, I ain't got no kids. Ain't trying to be able to say it, dog. I know that you did.